It puts things into perspective a lot more. A lot of dynamics of what's on the line, you know, all that changes. When you have points to gain and you know you're working towards something, then every match becomes of that much more importance. So, as I said, it's going to bring in more competition, more requirement of concentration, precise cricket, a lot of discipline as well. So I think the Test Championship and the format that it brings with it is going to take the standard of Test cricket higher. And that's what we are looking forward to and expecting to happen in any of the series that we play from here on.
I want to go back to the earlier series, the last time India played Test in Australia. You won the series but lost the Test at Perth. In one session it got away from you. What kind of lessons did you take and the young group that you talked about from the loss at Perth and the win in the series as you go into the World Test Championship?
Well, the loss at Perth, obviously, it gave us a pretty fair idea of what we needed to do. In terms of going into the next test in Melbourne and how we needed to approach the game and how professional we had to be. And that's why we ended up winning that important test and then, you know, drew in Sydney again to win the series. But I think the fact that we had won one test and then lost another, we knew that we have to be absolutely at our best to win a series there. So it's all about correcting your mistakes very fast and learning quickly from the losses, and that's what the Test Championship will bring as well. Not all the teams are going to win all games. There'll be losses, there'll be draws, there'll be victories. So the team that learns from it quickly and on to the next test, they improve those things. Those teams are going to be the most consistent and, you know, in the hunt to be on top in the Test Championship. So we've learned quite a bit. We've learned composure. We've learned the need to you know, capitalize when the situation is with us and the need to control damage when things are stacked up against us. I think that's the most important part of Test cricket.
Do you have a playing 11 in mind?
We're still thinking about the combination. Obviously, we couldn't have a look at the wicket at all. It was still covered. So after having a look at the pitch, it's more or less a choice between you know, three quicks and a spinner or two quicks and two spinners. And last time England played here, the wicket had quite a bit of variable bounce. So all those factors come into play. But yeah, we're very flexible and open at the moment about what is the combination we want to go in with. Well, the good thing is everyone looks good. Everyone looks pretty confident of their skill sets. That's always a very comforting thing as a captain to understand that all players are ready and available and you know, at full fitness and in a good headspace as well. So, as I said, then according to conditions, you are in a great position to pick the 11 that you want and which suits the combination best for the team according to where you're playing. So, we're in a good space right now to take that call. And everyone got a decent outing with bat and ball and in the field as well. So I think these kind of games always help you tick a few boxes, especially for the guys who came in and hadn't played a lot of cricket on this tour. For us who have been playing for a while now, it was just about, you know, staying in that frame of mind to do well for the team, being disciplined. But for the guys coming in, always these tour games are important to just have a match situation and, you know, execute your skills out there in the middle, which is, I think, very, very important. I think we need to continue the good work we did in Australia. From England, we learned that, again, as I said, damage control is very, very important. We can't lose six wickets in a session. That way you have no sort of comeback possible in a test match, especially when you're playing against quality sides. And as I mentioned, every team knows how to, you know, take wickets now and capitalize sessions. So we'll have to be very precise. If we lose a couple of wickets, we'll have to, you know, address the situation accordingly, make sure that we play professional cricket, be disciplined, and, you know, let the situation get better for the team. Test cricket is all about, you know, earning the right to play well in a situation and make it favorable for yourself. You can't go out there and try to dominate a situation when it's stacked up against you. you need to show discipline. So I think we did that well in Australia. That's why we won. We learned that from England. And now it's all about creating and continuing those good habits in all the test series that we're going to play. I love coming to this place. Antigua feels really, really relaxing, and it's a very calming feeling coming here every time. And yeah, it's very special in terms of getting my first double hundred. And I remember just things just flowing and happening in that test match. So yeah, it was a beautiful feeling to have achieved that. And it's always good coming back here.
In the Australia series, you got three different opening combinations. The same opening combination that Sydney is going to be playing possibly here. Does that add any further, you know, Pujara had a phenomenal series and you had a very good series too. Does that add any further pressure to number 3 and 4?
Not at all. We are senior players. We want to take the bulk of the load. And that's why we are in those positions as senior batsmen in test cricket, along with Jinx. I think three of us have been playing for a while, and we want to control that, you know, middle order and take a lot of the load off the other players. The opening combination, as you can see, we've only selected two openers in the squad. So the idea is to give them, you know, four innings, just let them go out there and express themselves and really come into their own. Mayank's done really well. KL's performed in the past. You know, he's really looking forward to making things count at the test level again. So, yeah, at the end of the day, as much as individuals want to perform, it's about what you can do as a team. If you look at the Melbourne test and how Vihari and Mayank opened, and the fact that Vihari scored only 18 or 20 runs, but he batted for 85 balls, tells you that it's all about the team. And, you know, he handled the situation so well that Pujara and myself could go out there and play the way we did. And then Pujara went on to get, that century for us. So I think these small contributions are not recognized or spoken about so much. But I think as a team, we all have markers set as to what's expected out of a certain batting position. And as you rightly said, it's up to them to capitalize on those opportunities and, just really express themselves in these four innings here.
During the tour, Coach Shastri mentioned about how Vihari going up with a stopgap solution and that you get a long run in the order. And also he played in the shadow tour, the media side, and he did quite well. Does that give him a leg up over your other choice? Possibly Rohit, who hasn't had the opportunity to play first class but performed phenomenally well in the World Cup?
Look, again, it all depends on the type of combination we want to go in with. Vihari's done really well since the time he's come in, you know, came into two difficult tours. Rohit's also done well in Melbourne. So it all depends on what kind of combination we want to go in with. Vihari gives you a few overs with the ball as well. And he's a pretty solid player, we know that. Rohit's quality, we all know. We've been seeing it for years. So again, it's about, you know, who provides the best balance in terms of the 11 we want to choose. But I'm just happy about, guys grabbing their opportunities. And as long as there's healthy competition for starting the game or, you know, contributing for the team within the group, I think that's a great thing for Indian cricket. And we're all very happy to be in that position where we have a problem of plenty and not, you know, having to find players from places. So I think it's always a great position to be in where we are.